Welcome.
We Are Still Here was released in 2015 and was directed by Ted Geoghegan. It stars Barbara Crampton and is about a family who moves to New England, where strange happenings begin occurring in the house. So I heard about this movie from the Dead Meat podcast, and it really sparked my interest, so I decided to watch it, and it was pretty good. I enjoyed it. I think the one thing that I don't really like about it is how overhyped it was by Rotten Tomatoes and by critics, which I'll kind of get into later, but I do want to start talking about some pros about this movie because there are a lot that I really enjoy. So, in terms of pros, I think the first one, which is by far the greatest part about this movie, is its special effects. It really doesn't use any CGI. I think in one scene there's like cigarette smoke that they CGI'd because you're not allowed to smoke in bars anymore. And like, it wasn't noticeable. I was like, oh, that's CGI. That was because I watched a video that told me that was CGI. But everything else was just special effects makeup and all of that. And it is fantastic, all of this special effects work that they do. I mean, I don't want to get into too many spoilers with this movie because, oh my god, there's so much that I want to talk about. Which, if you do want to hear some spoilers with this movie, I will be talking about it on the Three Strangers podcast later on this week. So be on the lookout for that. But the special effects, amazing. Our main antagonist special effects, phenomenal. I mean, I was really impressed with all the special effects work that was in this movie. I think another pro that I have with this movie is this tone switch that happens within the middle of the movie. Because the first half of it, it's really cliched. There's a lot of stuff that we already know. And although they try to flip some things on its head within the genre, it still feels very cliched. And I don't think it's a negative, but I don't think it's a positive either. It's just kind of what we've already seen, but with a new movie and a new story. But this flip that happens halfway through the movie, and I'll kind of say it's when they introduce these two characters. Oh my god, it becomes a completely different movie. It becomes so crazy and just so much happening that you think you're watching a different movie for the first half. And I will say the first half, you do have to watch it. It is necessary. You do learn a lot of plot and stuff within it. And it's not like boring plot. It's a lot of uncovering of what happened to this family. But the second half of this movie is so much fun. So after speaking on those positives, I do need to speak on some negatives, which, like I said, I do think this movie was too overhyped. And after watching the podcast and hearing about it, I was interested. I looked it up. So that had 95% on Rotten Tomatoes. I looked up some reviews on YouTube. They were like, this is one of the best movies of the 2010s, the best movie of 2015. There was a lot of hype going into it, but the audience score was like a 72, like kind of low. So I was interested to see why it was like that. And after watching it, it's a good movie, but it's severely overhyped. I don't think it's the best movie of 2015. It is a good movie, but just the level of extent that they were saying how great this movie was, I don't agree with. And I think a lot of people went in with that expectation of watching this masterpiece of a film. And you don't get that. You get a good film. But I think because of that, a lot of people then were saying, oh, this is a terrible movie. It's not as good as people are saying. But I do think it's a good movie, don't get me wrong. But it was severely overhyped. Oh, one more thing that I do want to say is I've seen a lot of people in negative reviews say that the acting is horrible. I don't agree. The acting is actually pretty good in this movie. I think that some of the decisions and writing could lead to people saying, oh, that was bad acting. But I think our actors in this movie did as great as a job as they could. I think that some of the writing of the characters weren't as good, which attributed to people saying that was bad acting. So overall, I'm gonna give this movie a 7 out of 10. And if anything in this review piqued your interest, I would say watch this movie. But if not, you know, if you're bored, you can watch it. But I wouldn't go and start recommending it around to people. So thank you everyone for watching this review, and stay tuned because on Tuesday or Wednesday, whenever Tina has this video up, which I'm not rushing her, you know, she could take her time. This is just Tuesday or Wednesday. There's going to be a very fun Thanksgiving horror themed video going on the channel. So I hope you stay on the lookout for that and watch it because it is going to be so much fun. After recording this video, I'm going to drive over to my friend's house so we can record it. So please be on the lookout for that video. But let's flash forward to the next review.